Hi, this is Jessie Burgess from Foundry, and through this video I'll take you through some of the basic troubleshooting you can use to solve your problem, or have the information you need when contacting support. The first thing we can do when troubleshooting is clear the cache by clicking on Cache and Clear All. In Studio, this will pause the viewer, so you would need to unpause it by clicking on the pause icon. We can clear the cache from the folder itself and find its directory in the preferences. If you have a custom path, you would see it here in place of the default environment variable. If we click on the folder icon, the file browser will appear and show us the path. Another way to find the path is by hitting X in the node graph and typing in getenv nuke underscore temp underscore dir. This will show us the same location that we saw in the preferences. Now we can go to that folder and see all the cache and localized files and directly delete the folders we want to remove. The default environment variable path in the preferences is used in other places in Nuke, which is why you will see not just the caching folders, but also the localized. The next option we can do is add some profile nodes into our scripts. With the profile nodes, we can measure the performance of our script at that point, which will help us troubleshoot which area in our script is using the most CPU or memory, as well as the ops, the number of operators being called in the node, and wall, the time in microseconds it takes for the processing to complete. The information is split into different graphs to visually see what each node is using, so we can narrow down where our problem is coming from. There are different ways to view this data, from bar to pie to timeline, which shows you the performance of the nodes across your frames, or table, depending on how you prefer to read the information. Alongside the profile node, we can use the buffer report, which can be found under the cache menu. With this, we can see an overview of the comp and which nodes are the heaviest, and can help narrow down a problem area and decide whether we want to add another profile node or not. Next, we can start working upstream and changing which node the viewer is plugged into. We can also start disabling nodes. We can move upstream by using the arrow keys and disabling our nodes with the D shortcut. This way, we can narrow down to an area and find out which nodes or node is causing the problem. This can end up being quite time consuming, especially when working with larger comps. So there are some other troubleshooting steps you can take to help solve your problem or narrow down what is going wrong. So the next thing we could do is the common turn it off and on again thing. Yeah, it can be that simple of a solution. There are two ways we can turn it off and on again. First, we can close the comp and keep the session open, either through the file menu or using the shortcut Ctrl W. The second option is to close the session completely and launch Nuke up again. Next, we can use safe mode. This gets mentioned quite a lot when troubleshooting, and to launch into safe mode, you can create a shortcut on your computer or in the terminal using --safe, along with which product you're wanting to launch. Safe mode will launch without any user customizations or third-party plugins, though it won't disable environment variables. This way, we can test to see if the issue still exists or not, and whether it was caused by something external to Nuke. Following on from that, the next option is the clearr.nuke. This can be found under your user account folder. Instead of deleting the folder, if we rename it to something else like old.nuke, this will force Nuke to create a new .nuke on launch. Doing this will reset all the preferences and Python scripts that existed in it, and anything external to the folder won't be affected, like the plugins or if you had set another path in the environment variables. Once launched, we can open our comp, and then looking back at the folder, we can see a new .nuke has been created and our old one hasn't been removed. The last thing I'll go over before jumping into Studio is that if you have access to a previous build of Nuke, you can see if the issue is an existing problem or something that is more recent. Having this information with you when you send in your ticket to support will help them look into your problem if you are unable to solve it with what we have gone over in this video today. If we jump into Studio, there are two things I want to go over. However, everything we have gone through so far, you can do in your review session. Firstly, when we're working with sequences or clips and the viewer stops updating, we can try swapping between the different clips or sequences to force the update. If that doesn't work, we can close the individual clip or sequence by clicking on the X on its panel. and then reopen it. Another area for troubleshooting is when working with audio. For example, you can hear audio from the computer, but it stops working in your session. You have checked to make sure it's not muted, and the frame rate matches that of your audio clip. So we can go into the preferences, and under audio device, swap to another option in the drop-down list. Then close the preferences by clicking OK. We reopen them, set the audio device back to what you want it as, and click OK. This can force the session to update and re-recognize your audio device. The last thing I'll go through will sound like the whole turn it off and on again, but this can be really useful and hold some information that can help when contacting support, either through the support portal or emailing them at support@foundry.com. But when you crash and get a crash report, it may be quicker to just close it, but if you fill in the details, send it through to them, the crash report is not the same as a support ticket, so you won't hear anything from support until you've created a ticket with them, as crash reports are anonymous. Make a note of the reference ID and send it with a copy of the report in your ticket. Today we have covered a few ways to do some basic troubleshooting. I hope you have found this useful, and thanks for watching.